Ndidi, have you not been noticing it?
Nem, I've been noticing it though. Urema, Ogeni, is there any problem? If there is anything, now you say it. Let's settle it. What happened more?
Urema, what is going on? Eh? Why are you hostile towards me? Honestly, you are acting as if we are contending for something.
We are contending over a lot. Eh? We are contending over your domineering attitude towards everybody.
Momo.
Yes! What is even wrong with you? Eh? Why do you always hang shoulders? You feel like you're better than all of us. What do you have that we don't have? I am asking you, what? Eh? Oh, you think you can deceive me? You think you can deceive us with this your nonsense basket making? It's not possible. You can't deceive me. Mm-mm. Nonsense.
What is bringing all this one? What is going on? Asim, what do I have that you don't? Look at me, because did I say you don't have front and back? Wait, is it true? What she say, is it true?
How is it true?
Do I hang my shoulders?
Maka, you like giving yourself problem. How is what she's saying true? See, Urema, count me out. I don't know what you're talking about. If there's any problem, say it. Obrie.
Urema, we are friends. I don't know where this animosity is coming from.
Imagine.
If there's anything, my friend, let me know.
Biko, don't even try to come close to me. If you try it, if this your height is even deceiving you, don't even come close to me again. Maka ma kuki duka duka keta. Ma kuki blue black now. Ndidi, ndidi.
Oh, push go push me.
Na ma kwami yo meleme.
Okay, who Rema pushed me?
Yes.
Who the organis?
Eh, e push me, gini weme.
Pushed me.
Gini weme zia.
Do you want
me? May he make a phone?
Hey, go away.
No, I'm
not going to go. You pushed me.
Oh, give me.
Here.
My queen.
My adorable Princess Adugo. The pride of Fiancée kingdom. The glittering morning rays that brightens the prince's heart. My son.
My latest royal bride. You're welcome, my dear.
Thank you, my
Look
queen.
At you.
My queen. Bring on the praises. Thank you so much. You're the best mother-in-law in the world.
Was a good one. In fact, you are the fairest of all the princesses that have treaded Mother Earth.
Really?
Yes.
Thank you.
Look at you. My beautiful future daughter-in-law. So how are you doing today?
Very well, my queen.
You look so classy. Ravishing, astonishing as ever.
Ah,
you're welcome, my dear. So, how are you doing today?
Very well, my queen.
How is your journey?
Very smooth. Thank you.
Come and sit. Come and sit.
Thank you so much, my
queen. I hope it's not stressful on you.
Not at all, my queen. It was smooth.
Okay.
But a man from this kingdom tried to ruin my day.
What? Who could that be? Just say the name and the culprit will face the punishment bitter than pains. Yes, how can?
No, my queen, don't worry. Trust me, I handled the situation.
Of course I do. I do trust you. So how are your parents?
Enjoying royalty as usual.
I can't expect less than that.
Sure.
Call Akuna to get more glasses.
My queen,
what?
I'd rather see the prince first.
Wow, I can imagine what my grandchildren will look like.
Cute as ever.
Okay, let me take you to him.
Thank you. I wish you know how much I miss you. Why is it so difficult for you to pick my calls or check on me? You seem not to miss me.
Of course I do. Just my busy schedules, that's all.
Busy indeed. You're too busy for your wife? Please don't patronize me with those silly excuses. I am not a fool.
Neither have I called you one. My apology.
I hope no woman is trying to take your attention away from me. Because I will not hesitate to kill her.
Oh. Father.
Son. You're welcome to my palace. How are you?
Very well, Your Highness.
What of your daddy, the king? My very good friend.
Very well.
I can see my son is already taking care of you. Your husband to be. Mm-hmm. Let me leave both of you to observe some privacy for intending couples.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Son.
That was very rude. How can you sit and greet my father, the king?
Are you serious? Do you expect me to roll on the ground just because of a mere pleasantries from your father? You know me better than that, that pretense is not my kind. I will not play the holier-than-thou character just to please my father or my mother-in-law. Besides, my father is a king. And he's a king to the kingdom, but he's my father. And I don't roll on the ground when I want to greet him.
Impressive. Very well then. Make yourself comfortable. I'll join you later. Excuse me.
Remember, don't keep me waiting.
I'm glad you observe it yourself. Each of her words and attitude spells pride and arrogance. Is that the kind of woman you want me to get married to? As a wife, father? One who visibly lacks home training? That's it?
I understand your point, son. But you see, there is absolutely nothing anybody can do about it. She is betrothed to you from childhood, and automatically that makes her your wife. I know if you work on her, she will definitely change to a new shape. I know you to be a vibrant young man that is cultured and a good mindset, an optimistic mindset. I trust you, son. I trust you.
Father, it is not easy to change an adult, especially one with so much pride and arrogance, like Princess Adogo.
Like I said, she will change. Okay? Well, I'm going to talk to the father, the king, about that. At least she will change to a better person. But for now, let's change this topic, son. Let's change it. How are you preparing for the forthcoming birthday celebration? Son? Talk to me, son.
Father. Mother.
Yes.
Since the date of my wedding and traditional marriage almost clashed with my birthday, I'm thinking to myself that there shouldn't be an elaborated birthday, since there is already a big feast around the corner. Secondly, I would like to bring to your attention that I would prefer a few friends in attendance for my birthday.
That's a nice decision. Yes. You see? I've always known that my son is not ostensible.
Well, since both of you have reached a consensus, son, put up a bill and I will mobilize you accordingly. I have made more than enough money that can take care of my family, even to the next generation. Come to talk about you, my son, I can go extra mile. I can do anything to make my prince happy.
Thank you so much, father.
You're welcome.
I'm so, so happy for you, son.
Thank you, mother.
I'm happy.
Yes.
I'm happy.
Thank you so much, mother.
I'm so happy.
Greetings, Your Highness.
Yes. Oh, don't worry. Don't worry. Yeah, we can do it ourselves.
Okay, Your Highness. Alright.
Sure, this would be prudent if I... Okay. I'm sorry.
When are you going to quit with your pranks?
Whenever you quit enlightened me with the angelic jiggles. How are you today?
I'm fine, thank you. And you?
Yeah, I'm doing pretty well. How about your parents?
They went out. They went to my maternal home. They'll be back in the evening.
Oh, good. So I can see that you are alone.
Yes, I'm alone.
Same here, the palace is so bored, so I thought otherwise to come out so we can go on our usual walk. And also remind you about the upcoming birthday celebration.
My prince, you don't have to remind me. How can I forget the birthday of a very special one? You know what, let me just finish up with the basket so we can go. Okay.
Okay, let me just help you then.
No, my prince. What would people say if they see you making a basket? Please.
What would people say?
What?
Man, take a look at this. Royalty looks good on you. And remember, we are one. Whatever you do is what I do. I've learned the craft from you, right?
My prince, you're a kind man. So special.
You are my angelic love. Come on, let's go.
Okay.
Okay, so it's gonna be much faster. My prover, right?
You learned!
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
So
you're
gonna be
good
letter. Okay. There we go. So we're gonna be here until the justice is cut.
My love, why the sudden change of mood?
That is because I am pained. My prince, do you realize how it hurts to know that you can never be mine? How it hurts to know that this fire of passion that burns in our heart will end sooner or later. Even while you're in my arms, it hurts to know that we can never be together. It hurts to know that you belong to another person. My prince, it hurts to live in this illusion we call love.
My love, what we have is not an illusion. It's true. It's pure. I understand how you feel. And I wish I can do something about it. To always wipe your tears when you cry. To always have a shoulder you can lean on when you're heartbroken and downcast. But if wishes are horses, faith is often a parcel. God knows we are in this together.
Greetings, Mrs. Akuna.
Ah, Ujunwa. How are you?
I'm doing fine, ma.
What is it?
The prince sent for you.
Oh, my prince. Tell him I'll be with him shortly.
Okay, ma.
Greetings, the kindest prince of our time. A man whose humility has encouraged the entire youth of our kingdom. God is always with you.
Greetings, Mrs. Akuna. You would not cease in amazing me with your praises and sense of humor, most especially your wisdom.
I'm honored. My prince, it is always a pleasure to be at your service.
As well honored. Please do have a seat.
Thank you, my prince. My prince, you are smiling, but that does not hide the fact that you are troubled. And that is why you sit here alone and sent for me.
You're right, Mrs. Akuna. You're very correct.
My prince, your restlessness testifies that the still water of love is troubled.
Indeed, it is. I went to see her today, and she said a lot of things.
facts. Disturbing facts. She reminded me of the fact that we can never be together. She reminded me of the fact that I am for another woman. She reminded me of the fact that we may dwell in perpetual emotional torture when we shall have finally parted. She also said that we are living in an illusion. I felt guilty. I couldn't defend myself. She was right about all what she said. Now I'm telling myself that we should quit instead of continuing our journey of no destination.
No, my prince. You don't have to say that. Every journey of beautiful destination, every journey of rosy end, always comes with obstacles. And those obstacles are designed by the evil forces to make you quit. But only the wise sees beyond today and continue trading. My prince, you are not a coward. Neither is she. She is only a woman. And sometimes, we are too weak to fight. And that is why we have a hero to keep us moving. The man in our lives. Amaka needs you now more than ever. She needs your courage. Please do not give up. The gods are with you.
Mrs. Akona.
My prince.
Thank you for your words of wisdom. You're always my strength whenever I'm weak.
My prince, it's not enough. You don't have to thank me. In fact, I should be the one thanking you for giving me a privilege to share in your problems. Yes, let me get your special coffee. It will help calm your nerves. Hey, do not forget to call her tonight. And tell her that you are a soldier, not a chicken to give up. Oh? Let me get your coffee. I'll be with you.
Igwe! Odogwu ikaleka. Odogwu nyumunya. Owe lo mageju neji aga nogwu. Mowogi deji awane igwen. Inanu no no bolidanu. Imana gwana bode na nanyamaro nkebu oke. Ode mazili weke mechini, odogu ikale kane.
Kuwe kareka.
Your Majesty. Obuja Nkembo no Munya Kingdom. You are indeed skilled in fluting. You won't cease to amaze me.
Oh, my king.
You have made my day.
I am glad you are entertained.
I'm happy. Let us go ahead to the business of the day. Actually, I invited the three of you because of my son's upcoming birthday and traditional marriage celebrations. They are coming simultaneously. They include dates. And as a matter of fact, I'll be expecting lots and lots of visitors. A lot of personalities will be in attendance. At least, we have to prove to the entire world that Omunya Kingdom has the best palm wine tapper and the best flutist that the world can provide.
Your Majesty, count on me. I'll deliver.
Okoro, my man.
Your Majesty.
Your assignment is not far-fetched. You shall provide all the cows and other livestock that will be needed for that occasion. Like I said, my friends in diaspora will be in attendance. Please, I believe I won't be disappointed.
I'm at your service, Your Majesty.
Yeah.
Your Majesty, as you all know, consider all these things done.
I don't expect less from you. Oh no!
Igwe!
Oh no!
Igwe!
Oh no!
Igwe Kareka!
I am happy.
Oh, Akoka!
Good. Hey, Ure, help me go through this later. Check if he's romantic enough for my other Sonny.
Hey, you know, I'm not super Anna. Okay, Sonny, my hero. My hero, I hope the angels are watching over you. I just want to check on you since you've refused keeping a date with me after my several requests. How is business and life generally? I hope God is with you, my love. I want you to know that I'm praying for you every day. I'm praying for our future. All I ask is that you give me a chance to be the rainbow and the sunshine in your rain, the fragrance on your beautiful skin, and queen of your heart. I wish to see you soon, and I want to know when it will be possible. Take care. My charming prince. Just forever and the Diamaka. Love wanting to. Anyway, you try, Sha. But the truth is that, you know you're wasting your talent. If you apply these skills in writing love novels, who is Chimamanda Chindi? She won't even see your back at all.
Are you trying to mock me, Uri? See, I don't want him to see that I don't know anything. I'm an itibori bo.
Money beat, you money beat now. But for this one, shall you try?
Honestly, I love Oga Sonny too much. Too much. Mm. The only problem I'm having is Chiamaka. That's the only problem. I don't know why she will not just, you know, focus on the prince and leave my Oga Sonny alone. Spinning me, but I know that all these things she's doing, there's no way she will get away with it. I, indeed, Amaka, will be the one to win over my Oga Sonny. She will not win over me. I feel that girl, she's using charm. If not, why will all these men be following her up and down like flies?
Akorum, she's not using any charm. You and I know she's very beautiful. See her height now. She has skills. We don't have any skill. We can't even patch our torn dresses. We can't even make ordinary broom they use to sweep house. I'm wearing Kai pasta. We are useless, so. Yes, da.
You are useless and not me. I am not useless. Oh? All I'm saying is that if she like, let her have all the skills. That's her business. I don't care. She will never take over my Sonny. Okay. Not why I am still alive. I will not allow it. After all, she's not finer than I am. If she's finer than you are, that's your business. She's not finer than I am. And she does not have it all. I have all the accessories. I have all of them. And I'm going to beat her to this game.
Bam. And it will be titled Battle of Love.
Before Uncle.
So get ready for war.
action.
Uri, forget about that Amaka before she will spoil what we want to do. I want you to help me deliver this letter to Oga Sunny.
As your errand girl or what? You've practically turned me to your errand girl, Abi. I can't do it free anymore. In this country, nothing is free. So you will need to pay for the courier service, you understand?
Are you not my friend?
Mm-mm.
Eh?
Mm-mm.
Uri, okay, see. You know that my skirt, the one that you've been begging me for, I'll give it to you.
Wait. You give me that you're really scared?
Eh?
That one I like so much.
Of course.
Are you serious?
I'll give it to you. Just help me deliver it.
Hey!
Will you deliver it?
Eh? It can address you. See what you do. Just close your eyes, eh? Close your eyes before you open it. Your message has been delivered. One touch, I will deliver the message. Now. Bring it immediately.
Package it very well. It to my Oga Sunny.
Sunny is yours, so.
I don't want anybody to see it, though.
Mm-mm, nobody will see it.
Then this one, too. Mm-hmm. Please give him as well.
Okay. Well, let's go.
Hey, but I don't want him to see me.
He will not see you. Hide somewhere and wait for me.
Yeah.
Well, good. Let's go now. I don't want him to.
True love never lies. True love never fails. No matter what it faces, true love must remain. True love never lies. True love never fails. No matter what it faces, true love must remain. What will be, will be.
Chiamaka.
Mama.
Ebeku Chiga.
You're back.
Hey, I'm still there. What were you thinking about that you did not even notice I have come back? Eh? Oh, Guinea.
Mama, where is Papa?
The Igwe called him. He needed him to come and blow flute for him. So he has gone there. What is it? Why are you so moody?
Mama, I love him. He has shown me what love is all about. But his parents' rejection keeps dashing my hope away.
You're still talking about the prince. His parents did not reject you. Fate rejected you. The rich marry the rich. And the poor marry the poor. Both of you are not in the same class. And that is why everything is falling apart. No, your own husband will come. Somebody that both of you are in the same class. Oh? Well, come, let's go and cook. Top?
Go.
The babella.
Let me wait here. Yes, you can go. Deliver the letter to him. But remember, don't tell him who wrote the letter. Let him read it and then understand. You know, go. I'll wait for you. Oh, yeah, now. Oh, you come.
What if I still don't want to go again? Will you do anything?
Go. Remember the promise, so.
Good afternoon.
Good
afternoon. Good. Hi, now. How are you now?
I'm fine.
You want some?
I'm a new fairy now. So. Fine, ma.
I hear.
Anyway, I have a letter for you.
From who?
It's a surprise till you read it. I mean,
okay. Tell her I have seen it. I'll get back to her. Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay. I think I should be leaving now.
Okay, no problem.
So take care of yourself.
I will. You too.
Sonny. Bye-bye.
Don't you trust me again? It was smooth and perfect.
Hey! Well, I trust you. I trust you.
That's how I miss your mama. I had to convince him that you're the best for him.
Hey!
Trust me. He was very, very excited. He was very happy and he promised to come and see you as soon as possible.
You're lying. Oga Sonny promised to come and see me. Hey! Really? Messi go kwami ni ni ge melo. You've done everything. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Hey, I'll be on my way. Oh, I'll see you later.
Hey. Again, where's my skirt now? So let's go together so you give me the skirt.
I will give you. I promised you. I will give it to you. But now I want to rush to somewhere. I'll see you.
This girl will try you limo. Hey. I will spoil the job now. I'll spoil everything.
My prince, our journey ends here today.
I wish the journey is endless.
But as you can see, it's a very short one.
Sure. promise me you'll see me tomorrow.
I will if I can get permission from my parents to go out.
Do you get permission from your parents? You see, whenever you crave for something so desperately, you will get it like I crave for you. You must get it.
Okay, fine. I'll see you tomorrow. It's a promise.
Cross your heart?
I cross my heart.
Okay, I'll see you tomorrow. Then.
Okay.
I'm gonna miss you, okay?
I miss you too. Take care of yourself.
Bye.
Is it? Did you forget anything?
Yes, I forgot you, my love. I already started missing you, so I decided to come back to see you off.
My prince, but you saw me at a disengaging point not too long ago.
Well, for me, that doesn't matter. As long as I can have a little more time with you and watch you smile like you're doing right now. You mean a lot to me, darling. I can even go to the moon just to be with you.
Aww. That is so sweet of you, my prince. I appreciate your love for me. And you know what?
What?
I love you right back.
Sing it. Yeah. Come on, let's go.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
I mean, come, Macau. Hey, I know this is not your normal basket that you used to go and sell in the market. Eh? I mean, this is special. Who is it for?
Well, guess.
Ha. I mean, Biko, I'm not in the mood for guessing. Tell me, who is it for?
Okay. Well, it's for my prince for his birthday. I hope he will like it.
Hey! Love one thing, why not? He will love it, not just like it. He will love it. This is beautiful. And like I said, this is special.
And of course, my prince is special.
Yeah. Hey, that means you'll be attending the birthday now.
I am not sure of attending the birthday, but I'll find a way to send him the gift.
So you make all these gifts and you will not attend the birthday. Wait. Ami, let me ask you. Why go through all this stress for the prince we all know that will soon be getting married to another woman? Eh? A princess from another kingdom. Uchegi or Dizikwe?
Well, Prince Obinna will always be my special friend. And he deserves everything I do for him.
Hey, my friend. Hey, Ami, you know you're my friend. I will always advise you. And if you will take my advice, leave the prince alone. The prince is not in your class. Yes! He's a prince. The prince of this community. You're just an ordinary girl, eh? And he's a prince. An ordinary daughter of a palm wine stapper.
I've heard you. Thank you, Miss Advisor. Thank you for telling me that I am an ordinary girl. And also reminding me that I am the daughter of a palm wine stapper. Darling. But let me tell you something.
even royals drink palm wine. You know, go.
My friend, eh? E manasi na agwaronti ebupu isi o soro gini o sori awe napo. Anyway, I'm just advising you as my friend, nothing more. I don't want you to start frowning or be getting angry, eh? I came to take my bag. I'll be using it tomorrow. So can I get it?
Should have said so since.
Chipukwa nochi, Ami. Chipukwa nochi. You're taking it already. Hey. Oh, the love, one thing. You don't make for me or is not the prince. The prince, me that is your friend. Which one will I get?
Just tell me. Tell me you're joking.
How can I be joking?
I've always known that girl Amaka is poor. But I don't know she's also classless. Eh? How can she think an ordinary brisket would be a gift befitting the prince on his birthday? Hey! We're big men, high-class gentlemen and ladies, we're present. Eh?
No. You need to see the decoration. How she was decorating. I even asked myself, me that is Amaka's friend, what has she given me? Nothing. But that's her business. Whatever thing she's doing, everything she's doing is not my business. My business is to focus on how to win over my Oga Sonny. Iyani no neme, obasalia.
Didi, I'm thinking of something.
What?
Have you thought of the possibility of this girl using charm to get men attracted to her? No. Then she will now pretend and use that her basket craftsmanship to cover everything up. Why we, Munagi now, will be struggling to get men attracted to us, but mm-mm. Think about it. Think. You've been following Oga Sonny up and down. No way. Me, Inko, no
a
man,
point.
No man at all.
Nne, you have a point, though. You have a point.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway. I'm going to see Oga Sonny. On my way back, I'll stop by to see you. But let me make one thing clear to you. Okay, Adareri, Yonye Mwanya. Rat does not eat something that belongs to a woman. Her eyes are open. My eyes are open. And Amaka, or whatever she calls herself, or whatever she's using, she will never take anything that belongs to me. Mark my word.
That's the spirit.
I will see you. Oh,
go.
Ngwan Kodi.
Go and take what belongs to you. Nonsense. Ndidi, why is your face like this? Eh? What?
I'm not happy. I'm not. I went to see Oga Sonny and he turned me down. Ure, you lied to me, right?
No.
You did! You told me that Oga Sonny has accepted to be with me. You told me that he was happy and he was expecting to see me. Then what happened? I went there and he told me that I can never be his. And that he can never be mine. Tell me, you lied to me, right?
I did not lie to you. I never lied to you now. He told me, he promised me that he will come and see you. That's what he told me. What?
I don't know what is wrong with Oga Sonny. I don't know what Chamaka has done to him. But whatever, I don't care. Oga Sonny must be mine. And nobody will change it.
We called you here as your parents to talk to you. We love you so much. Our priority is not just for you to be successful in life, but for you to be fulfilled and be happy in future. We are against your relationship with that young lady, Chiamaka. Not just because we hate her. I don't have anything personally against her. But you can see, she do not represent royalty. She's a commoner. Not just a commoner, but one whose ancestral trail is not qualified to dine and wine with royalty. Son, I am your father, and automatically you are my son, and that makes you heir apparent to the throne. It then becomes imperative that you live up to expectations as a future king of Omunya Kingdom. Prove to your people that you have the prowess, the ability, and the capability to rule your people. That girl do not have pedigree. Son, I will forever be your father anytime, any day. I believe you will take a wise decision. The choice is yours. We love you, son.
Think about it, son.
She is not worth to cost you the precious things you deserve. You just have to let her go. Yes.
Father.
Son.
Mother. I've heard you all. I'll think about it.
The earlier you do that, the better for all of us. I hope you take the right decision, son. We love you.
Excuse me.
This situation is becoming very serious. I do not know why my father do not want me to be the one to make the choice of a woman that I will spend the rest of my life with. Royalty and wealth is supposed to be freedom. But no, here I am. I'm not free. I've gotten to the level of adulthood where decision making is supposed to be solely mine and mine alone. Unfortunately, I'm tied to slavery in a marriage of hilarious life of loyalty.
Amakamo ibu love mo, aminwa ibadi no bi mo, mbabu lamfudu, obi na di mama, lega nyana nya, love ebur mugaba.
Ifuna nyamo, love aniga digide, onye kemo. Nana niga digide onwe onye dekewa onwe ihe dekewa oyoyo ntemo ibu onye mforo nanya onwe onye dekewa onwe ihe dekewa oyoyo ntemo ibu onye mforo nanya.
There is something I have to say to you.
Okay.
I know it's difficult for me to say, but I guess I have no choice.
What is it, my prince?
I have deeply thought about our relationship, and I've come to understand that everything you said, you were right. That our relationship is a journey of no destination, a battle without a victory. Something has to be done. There has to be some sacrifice made for us to be together. Something that I don't wish to jeopardize. It is obvious that my family would not bless this union. And I don't want to disobey them. If I venture in getting married to you, they will not give their blessings. Should I do that, none of us will know peace in our marriage. So I have decided to obey them in the interest of peace. please, my love. I have decided to follow their wish, and that is to marry Princess Adogo. Just for the sake of peace, I beg you, please, try and understand.
I understand. I mean, you have to do what your parents want, right? You don't have to compromise because of me. So, I understand perfectly well. I wish you best of luck in your future marriage with the princess.
Please promise me that you'll come for my birthday party.
No, I won't. There's no need for that.
My instincts were right after all. You are here playing hide and seek with that lunatic while I am waiting for you and looking for you everywhere in the palace. Why?
Adogo, I'm not in the mood for your problems.
Are you serious? I said it. So you've been crying. Look at tears rolling down your eyes. You've been crying for that pauper, that commoner, that nobody. My prince, do you know the magnitude of your action? Do you know what you've done? A prince, heir apparent to the throne, kneeling and crying for that nobody. What is wrong with you? A girl that is not even worthy to be called a palace.
Princess Adogo, I'm not in the mood for your cantankerousness. Excuse me.
This is not over. We shall settle this before the king. This is not over. How dare you? Come and talk to you.
Amaka. Oh, what is the problem? Why are you looking nervous? Is anything the matter?
To be honest, Ndidi, I am not only nervous, but scared. Honestly, I am scared.
Wait, oh. What are you scared of? Were you not the person that said that we should go to the palace?
Yes.
That you want to hand this beautiful gift to the prince. So why are you nervous and scared? Hi. Amaka, you can never change. See, let's go to the palace. When we get there, you will hand this over to the prince. He will be so happy.
You think I'm doing the right thing?
Of course, you're doing the right thing. Let's go. When we get there, hey, the way I will be dancing, they will know that we are there.
we go that way.